Hi, I'm Leslie Odom Jr. and Failing Up is available on Audible right now. I didn't think that I was the right one to write a book. I didn't think, you know, it was time. I was a little young to try to write a memoir or something like that. But the publishers had heard about my work with young people, with college kids and stuff, and how I enjoy that. And they came up with the idea, well, what if you wrote a commencement address? And so I wrote the book to speak to people and offer them some encouragement and use some of the lessons from my life to encourage them and inspire them in those moments of transition, those graduations. The central lesson that I covered in the book was the best piece of advice that I'd ever gotten from a mentor who got me off my couch. He really drummed in the lesson and taught me the lesson once and for all that it was my responsibility to fill the hours of my day. You know, it's tough. You know, following a dream is tough, but you have to do what you have to do to retouch that joyful pursuit again. Preparing for this, I definitely wanted to listen to some people who've done it well, because it's a very new thing for me and it's a skill that some people are good at, and I wanted to be good at it. Actors are our avatars. They are our stand-ins. When a performer stands on stage and bears her soul, she bears her soul for all of us. When a man stands on stage and lets his heart break, he lets it break for all of us. There is an invitation to participate, but we're also free to observe and learn. We elect them to do us this service, our theater stars and our movie stars. The same is true of the great singers. We elect them. I'm thinking of Marvin Gaye, Smokey Robinson, Barbara Streisand, Tina Turner, Bruce Springsteen, Jay-Z, Kanye, Nina Simone. They don't just sing for us. They sing for us. I had a really great director on this audiobook and a really great environment to work in. And I've obviously spent a lot of time with these stories and telling these stories and writing them down and editing them and getting them perfect. But I said, you know, somebody's gonna be hearing these things for the very first time. And so I really tried to go back to connecting to the impulses, the original impulses that made me feel like it was important to include this in the first place. Why this story? It felt right in this moment where I'm so incredibly fortunate and, you know, have found my way to so many of the things that I've dreamed about since I was a kid, to hold right next to that the reality of what it felt like to be a struggling actor, what it felt like to be somebody that felt locked out. I hope it's inspiring to somebody else who's got their nose pressed up against the glass.